Hi there. You might have noticed that Gmail changed something the other day that's quite significant, and that is the way you compose new messages. So you've still got the compose button as you've always had, but when you click on it, what happens now is this panel opens up down in the bottom corner here, and this is your new compose window. Now it's a little bit different to what we've had before. It's a lot more streamlined. You can see it's a lot cleaner. There's a lot less stuff around here, which is good and bad, as long as you know where to look to find the other stuff. So that's what I want to just run you quickly through. So one of the advantages, first of all, why did they do it like this? You notice that this window doesn't move. I can't pick it up by the black bar and move it anymore. In fact, you can pop this window out. You'll notice there's a little diagonal arrow here, which is a pop-out button. If I click that, I can in fact, oh, it's gone to my other screen. I can in fact pop that window out and have a floating window. So you can still get that effect of having a floating window if that's what you like by popping it out. However, by default, I'll just do it again, click Compose, it is in fact in a static window that doesn't move. The advantage of that is if you wanted to still keep working in the background, you notice that I can still, open up this email in the background, I can still read that, I can go back from there, I can look at this one. So I can in fact navigate around my emails while I've got this new message window open. That's a bit of an advantage. The other thing is if I click the compose button again, I can actually have multiple compose windows open. So you can be composing more than one email at a time. So there's two advantages there of having it this way. Just open one again. Just run you through it. So you put in your to here. So if I'm sending a message to someone, you just type in the name as usual and it populates. You can type in the subject there. Just like so. If you wanted to send to someone else to CC or blind copy someone, you can just click into the to field and you'll see the CC and the BCC appear there on the side. So I can click that and I can sort of add a third party like that. So it's easy enough to add people. Down the bottom here, if I decide I don't want to send this anymore, I want to discard this draft, there's a little trash can in the corner where I can click to discard the draft like that. Let me just open it one more time. The buttons that you used to get to change fonts and change the kind of the format of the text is hidden down here where the little A is next to the send button. And so you can see it opens up there and now I get a row of formatting tools. The little button next to it that looks like a paperclip, attach files. If I click that, it will pop up a window and ask me what to attach. Next to that, there's a plus key. You can see there's a little plus arrow there. If I mouse over it, that's how it lets me insert photos, insert links, and coming soon, the ability to insert emoticons and insert invitations to a calendar event. So there is some functionality that is missing at the moment from what you used to be able to do. So for example, canned responses, I don't know if you use that, but canned responses are not a feature of the new interface yet. I believe they're working on it. For most people, though, you should find that this is a much cleaner interface, much easier to use. So it's good like that. Just down in the, get that pop-out gone. Down in the bottom corner, there's a little arrow button. If you click that, there's some more options. If you really hate this new interface for composing, you can switch back to the old compose mode, and you'll get it the way it always used to be. But bear in mind, they will eventually phase out the old compose mode anyway. I'm told on reasonable authority that this new method of composing will be the only option we have from early 2013. So if you can start getting used to it, it's probably a good idea. All right, so that just runs you through some of the basic features of the new compose window in Gmail.